if we are, it will be as slave labor until we are no longer useful, and then we will simply be exterminated. The message to the vast army of initiates in the mystery school was, we are on the threshold of the new age, and into this new age will march only one man. It is the new man. It is the illumined man. It is the man that is able to make the evolutionary jump to no more war, to no more rape, no more pillage, to the level in the mystery school known as 666. It is the number of a man. It is the illumined man to the mystery schools. To those of us who are Christians, it is the symbol, mark of the beast, the indication that the Antichrist has arrived, and the beginning of the time predicted in the book of Revelation known as the Tribulation. Now, all of this that I thought I knew so well and understood has become even more mysterious to me now, as I know that I am battling against something that is almost incomprehensible, and I have had to do it alone, by myself, not trusting anyone else, not letting them in, for fear that they would corrupt my mind and I would be led down the wrong path. And I still do not know the answers, but I have an awful lot of clues and a lot of facts, and I've learned an awful lot. And maybe I am more confused than I ever was in my entire life. But after you hear the results of what I've learned, and after I am, for the first time since I've learned all of this, communicate it to other human beings and let you know how really confused I am, maybe all of us being confused together can put the pieces in their places and patch this mystery together and come up with what we need as answers to formulate a future that we can all enjoy. Without fear, without wars, without lies and deception and manipulation, without elitists and terrorists and crooks and liars. For I'm going to impart to you during all of this that the priests of the ancient mystery religion are the ones who have caused most of the misery in the history of man. And if they had not learned this knowledge, the secrets of the ages that they keep from the rest of us and use to manipulate us, maybe we would have reached peace in this world hundreds of years ago. I don't really know the answer to that, but I don't think much of what has happened in the history of the world that was miserable, terrible, would have happened without these people. But I may be wrong, and as always, when you listen to the show, don't believe a word you hear unless you could substantiate it in your own research. At the end of the movie, what you saw as the astronaut became older and aged, and this was the symbol of gaining knowledge and wisdom. And he looked at himself, and he saw himself younger, and he looked back and saw himself older, and he looked back, and he was older still, and he looked back, and he was young again, and then old. And then he saw this unbelievably overpowering, stunning vision of a fetus, a human fetus, floating in the great vastness of the universe, signifying the birth of the new age and the new man that will go into the future. Now, in the sequel to 2001, you saw that this astronaut who had made the jump came back and talked to some select few, signifying that he had then become a teacher to the rest of us. And when he was asked what happened to him, he said, and I quote, "Something wonderful," unquote. Now that was supposed to tell the rest of the initiates in the world who really understood the symbology of the movie that if they were able to make this transition, the future would be a utopia. Now I don't know whether it will be or not. But I can tell you this. The priests of the ancient mystery religions are in charge right now, and we had better damn well find out, and we had better do it very quickly. For the new age is the age of Aquarius, and the exact date of the dawning of the age of Aquarius can be determined astrologically. And I'm not going to tell you what that date is, although I have it right here on a piece of paper in front of me. I want you all to help in this search. God knows I need help. I can't save us all alone. And there's always the possibility, because I am human, that I could make the wrong decisions or make the wrong interpretations.